hips and just bringing them through a range of motion.
Yeah.
When I bring them through that big circle arc range of motion, I'm like, where's the tension? Now, when I make, so real quick, when I make the hip circle, when I make the hip circle real small, that's going to be the dim light. When I make the hip circle real big, where you start to find it.
So does it matter where
I'm sitting in questions, just let us know. We're going to have lunch before too long, maybe the next hour or so, and we'll have a marketing discussion after lunch. So if you guys have questions, just ask and I'll answer as I can.
I think that's where that's at.
Yeah.
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 Is everybody coming to everybody's verses?
So I thought about this recently. How many states require trans
students to scrape your skin?
And she's like, I don't know if it did anything.
Because I'm teaching online like
over
oh dude, I should do it 10 to 15. Because I have to have it every year I'm born, and I'm like, dude, I would think the most epic class ever. It would be like a farce. It would like make fun of the size regulation and like differentiate ethics and morals from law. No, law, that's just not a deal with. Ethics is where we have moral fortitude and speak according to our true beliefs.
This is like a provoking question.
We can have, you know, we can have Kierkegaard and Nietzsche argue.
I even had an high school choice in that, like, I took him and his cross country team was doing.
Kantian ethics.
He's like, should I do this?
How are you doing?
It's too short.
Yeah. Than I did when I was like in my teens or whenever it came out. Love the film. They're going to find the Holy Grail. But then when I watched it in like 2018 cultural context, what I noticed was the Nazis weren't really people. The Nazis would just like get run over by a tank, you know, shot in the background, and you were like, just a Nazi. And I'm like, this is horrible. They dehumanized Nazis. Nazis are decent people. And I started having this conversation amongst younger, say, millennial social justice warriors who very quickly were like, no, we do not tolerate Nazis. And I'm like, wow, you're very intolerant.
They were people too. They were just, you know, they were just kind of lumped to this
I'm like,
system.
That Nazi had a mom. That Nazi had a grandma. That Nazi had people who care about him.
Were they also Nazis?
And they're like, but they're Nazis! And
there's
like,
there's that book, Them
well,
the Nazis.
I mean, some Nazis are good people.
Well, they could have begun for...
There were some Nazis who just happened to live in Germany at a certain time and go, well, I don't really want to fight.
That's true.
And bought the party line. Trump supporters? We'll record,
that's
the recording.
Uh-oh, Twitch.
Yeah. No. It's just it's weird to me because it's like we are against hate except this one group of people.
Don't even have
it.
Don't even make any sense. The first
one started. I'm not making justification. Please don't write me any hate. It's just something I find interesting.
Right, like bullying cannot apply here.
Well, and I was joking about it from like a, you know, a movie standpoint. It was like, you don't have any feeling about like the background to get shot or whatever. You're just like, they're not the main character, Harrison Ford.
Happens all the time.
They're the hero. But those sorts of ethical, you know, considerations. I'm also told that a lot of the medical advantages that we have based on Nazi experiments, when we basically
accept
all their data and information, when the Chinese were, I think, or was it the Japanese? It was the Japanese and the Chinese experimenting on people in prison camps. And basically we said, okay, we're not going to punish you as long as you give us all your research.
Yeah, and
the Soviets.
Yeah,
weird sort of ethical issues.
Yeah,
yeah. Once you get into bioethics, you get closer to like abortion related issues and life issues. You really can't handle it with who can handle it.
Yeah,
it pushes up against their sense of justice.
Sure.
Yes.
That was the
ticket.
But, I mean, we live in a world with flat earthers. So. Let's just keep it in
perspective.
We have access to Google, and people believe there's a flat Earth. There are people who are petitioning to get a reality show to get flat Earthers to like walk to the end and see if they fall off.
Oh, that would be nice.
Yeah, that's funny.
Bye-bye.
And there was like this cardboard box.
Now I'm gonna bring it down.
Ball in the front.
Okay.
I was like,
yes.
What is that? And she was like, it's my diagram of how the Earth is flat. And I was like, you go,
what?
I can't. We're gonna talk about something else right now.
Like,
it was a serious
thing.
Yeah, I was like,
yeah.
I'm waiting.
Do you know when
we're Nazis? I'm like, no. Don't take me out of context. That's not what I said. That's not what I said.
Okay.
Just try to help.
No, waste your time.
Okay, so you're
going to
do all those
you can. I find over time that the range of acceptable discourse gets smaller and smaller. My father had a conversation recently. My father talked about communism, socialism, and Bernie Sanders in the same sentence, and they were all the same thing to him. And I went, those are not the same thing. Bernie Sanders is not a communist. He does not believe that the state should confiscate all private property. that's not what Bernie Sanders
have,
that was not his platform.
Right there.
You know.
Right there.
Yeah.
How are we doing?
That's awesome.
So, if you have your knee more on the side, that's one thing. If you bring her over and you put your knee in her gluteals, so move your knee in a little closer. This is going to stack high.
My legs work, but I didn't
hear
it.
It's going to be pointy.
Okay.
Okay.
This is more like pigeon pose.
Okay.
And then pull her onto your knee. Grab her thigh.
Are you seeing that?
And this will normally recommend you're smaller than me. So it did make a good model experience. When I have someone who's much larger than me, it's better. Because I can manhandle and hold them on. How's that? Pressure. But it's pressure while she's on her back.
Wow.
Right.
Yeah, that's
all the way. Yeah.
I mean, most people that have no issues with saying Hitler was evil.
How
did
you do
that? Maybe Hitler was a frustrating artist.
Hitler actually was like, he loved dance.
And
he said,
he
was
creative.
Yeah, but
genocide. And it's like, Hitler killed the Jews. And I'm like, well, technically it wasn't Hitler, it was Hitler's followers. Hitler doesn't have a lot of power unless people go, oh, that's a good idea. So is the problem, you know, the leader or the public? Ooh, Robert, this is, I want my money back.
Okay. Well, actually, what
do you do? How we doing? Do you guys understand the compression? Pulling them onto your knee? There's a difference between this, which is stacking, and this, which is more pointy and pulls a little sharper.
Can we do the roll?
Yeah, okay.
Yeah,
he's
sliding
on
the
sheet.
He's in like that.
Hey guys, if you have any questions, feel free to chat and ask. I'll answer as I can.
Not quite there, though.
Kind of,
it kind of
happened.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
No.
Oh, man. There's so many classes.
I don't like it.
It's
I'm
probably
going to
go to
I just don't know if I need to be sitting there.
I think
you can
like
put
in
your
door
frame
and
bring your foot.
Facing her this way and pull them back towards me. But the table's really low, right?
Yeah, it is low.
Exactly.
I don't know if that's the same.
Oh,
do you feel?
Lean back and stretch you. Can you?
I mean,
it,
I don't know.
It isn't.
It's like
no,
it's minor.
I like the sitting. That was really comfortable with
you. Your table's really low.
Yeah. Oh, see,
if you saw me do this on a mat, it's 20 times
easier.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll
let you
know
when it's good. So, do it just like that. Okay. Because I already feel like
it.
Yeah, that's a glitch.
Okay.
Yeah.
But they're like, mm-hmm. But the clients want a massage.
I like to go hard with them, so I need to find some
like, what's a massage? Yeah. But it's also, I think, also in the therapy, yeah. Do you know what I mean? That you need to constantly be moving in order to, like you said,
it depends on what the clients come out for.
Right.
And what are we trying to do?
Oh, no, I like the deeper and I end up working, and it's slower, and it's harder. But in the beginning, it was really, it was hard for me to transition my brain from going static, you know, compressions to compressions.
It's why it's important to take CE classes with different providers.
Yes.
You'll get different perspectives than people like me. You know, if you love deep work, go take a female sacral therapy class. Completely not science based, right?
It's really good too.
Oh man, if I post a craniosacral book in a pain science group, they lose their minds. And I'm like, oh, nice to throw the baby out of the bathwater. The people who talk about skin traction want nothing to do. And I'm like, have you read the book? And they're like, no. And I'm like, okay, baby. It's like I never like when I did trigger point work.
Yes.
When I did trigger point work and help people with stuff, did I ever once go, "What is the science behind this?" I went, "Is it effective?"
Yeah.
Cool. We'll figure out the science. Let's keep working at it.
Right.
But right now, this guy hurts. I'm suppressing his infraspinatus. Oh, is that in front of your shoulder? All right. Cool. Right there. Like there's a scientific reason it works that way, but we don't like cut on people and experiment to find out, you know, let's cause them pain and do research.
Yeah, that's true. They get pretty wild, but some things work for some people.
Mm-hmm. So, in the course of the class, I haven't talked about energy lines. I also haven't told you you have to do it this way. You have to use this tool. Each person is going to be completely. The goal is to give you more tools so you can select the appropriate tool at the appropriate time. That's all. When you talk about, you got to keep moving, because the client wants a massage. It's our job as therapists to educate the public on what the potential is. Mm-hmm.
And then we get a chance to decide what kind of work we really want to do. Because do you like relaxation or do you like pain and stuff?
I like more on therapeutic work. You know?
Yeah.
Because the relaxation, I'll just sleep.
Yeah.
I don't need to pay for it.
And then what we want to do is give you enough tools and enough business savvy that you can create the practice you want to create outside of envy if you don't want to stay there forever.
A lot of people actually just come like if we have problem, right? And it's kind of nice to work with those people that so actually you fix, you know?
Right.
Instead of just like lay down there.
The reason I liked pain relief was I had a more of a knack for it, and the people didn't care what I used.
Right.
Because
like, I'm in pain.
As long as
and
you're
it
really
feels like you accomplished something after the session.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, and I was like this because I had pain. Do people in chronic pain care that I'm a guy?
No.
Do chronic pain people care that I have opinions about Nazis?
No.
Which I also don't post on my social media. And that's the thing, it's like you could get away with a wider range.
Yeah.
And it was like, as long as you help them with pain, it's like I became sort of an honest mechanic. I would work on them and say, hey, listen, that thing in your performance, like I think you can work on that yourself. I'll give you a tennis ball and show you how to do it.
Right.
And
right.
They're like, whoa, that's crazy. Wow. He like actually didn't want me to come back. He wanted to fix the car.
It's just like did you really do like.
But let's say you get more referrals.
Yeah. I told him, whenever you feel bored, you're
watching I'll do something.
Yeah.
Oh, the stretch. Oh, the stretch. Oh, that was the one that came across. That was the one that
was good. It was on one of your shoulders.
Oh, I think that's.
She
tied your foot on your shoulders.
Yes. Here. How is
the pressure on your left?
It's good. So when we, like I addressed it initially as like lesions, but when we work on the hip, we work on the leg, what other structures did we access? Just what we did just now, a train. Because it wasn't just piriformis.
It definitely
feels different.
Low back.
IT
band.
Yeah.
Adductors. Because it's just a hip range of motion. There was me initially talking about, okay, you know, this is how you pull the people onto your knee to compress. And then here's how we generally bring knee to opposite shoulder to lengthen and stretch piriformis. But there's a wider range depending on where you move them.
Mm-hmm.
When I talk to students about theory, I said pick up the client, move them around, find the tension, and release it. That's all it was. Some people, a guy won't know exactly what's going on, and I'll move her around. It's like, she can go across her body fine, but when I bring her out in the open, she's like, adductors. When I bring her lap, and I go, oh, wow, her adductors are tight. Then I would put her in what looks like tree pose and do some gentle compression and work on her adductors. That's how I decide what line to work. The slip center are just a real basic map. And then Mr. Miyagi said, go paint the fence. Show me wax on, wax off. The clip from The Karate Kid that I would play was Danielson going, hey, Mr. Miyagi, I'm done. And he's like, what? And then he points around the perimeter of the fence that looks a mile long. He's like, don't forget to breathe. That is what SIPSEN are. I'll bank on that. When I said, listen, why is the Thai massage community not looking at pain science? They're like, it's not traditional. And I went, you're relying on the medical savvy of people from 2,000 years ago? Dude, we have antibiotics now. Like, are you out of your mind? There was a thread in a traditional Thai medicine group where somebody said that they had
before no computers.
A sinus infection. They said, my client has a sinus infection. I want to know what herbs I should recommend. And I was like, the person has an infection near their brain. give them antibiotics, and then we can discuss what herbs we may give them in addition. Please, you people are destroying my faith. What are you doing? Like, I don't want somebody to die because you were relying on Amish medical care.